Welcome back to the channel. Today we have something different than your normal broadcasting. I had an assignment. Let's just jump right into it, folks. Hit that like, comment, and subscribe button.
This is CNN breaking news.
Obesity is crazy common. So, it affects a lot of people. It probably could affect you. I mean, you are sitting at home watching my YouTube video, probably sitting on the couch eating popcorn, or you're in my class right now and you're watching the video and you're like, come on, Seth, make this funny, and where's the jokes? But obesity is very common. It affects 39.8%. I'm looking at the computer right now so you can see my facts. It's on the CDC website. Very cool. Percent of adult Americans in America. So there's 93 million people affected by obesity. And you might be wondering, what is obesity? What is technically obese? Obesity is when your BMI is over 30. And if you don't know what your BMI is, it's basically body mass index. And it's like your height and your weight, they come together and then you get a number. And you want to be below 30 to be healthy and not obese. So there's like a lot of reasons why you shouldn't be obese. There's a lot of complications. There's a lot of morbidity and mortality associated with obesity. So, you know, there's like a huge, I mean, most of you watching are probably high schooler or college aged, or my mom. Thanks, Mom. Some of the risks involved in being obese are high triglycerides. Got them. Diabetes. You know, diabetes is pretty bad. It's a whole nother thing, you know. You get your foot chopped off. You could just have to pay for insulin, and you know, who's got money, who's got time for that? Let's try and save you a dollar a day. A penny saved is a penny earned in my book. So there's high blood pressure, metabolic syndrome, there's heart disease, one of the leading killers in America, folks, especially for men. Gotta watch that. There's stroke, various types of cancer. There's breathing disorders. There's a huge stigma behind being obese. You know, some carbs you can't even fit into if you're so obese. Let's not let that happen. So, what are we going to do to solve this issue? You might be wondering, Seth, you know, you're usually throwing eggs at yourself inside a shower. And you're right. I usually am. You know what you're saying to yourself? Seth, you have a tattoo of pizza on your leg. And you know what? I haven't had pizza in like 2 days. So there's that. So the biggest things with obesity are diet and exercise. Diet. Y'all know I love my diet soda, and I'm going to be putting all my sources in the description down below. Buy my merch. I don't have some anymore, but you can check my sources and make sure that I'm accurate. Not everything you see online is accurate. But today, we are talking about physical activity. It's pretty important, turns out. And it's also fun, you know? There's been studies that say, you know, being outside, being active, raises your happiness level. It releases hormones. You know the ones. It releases them. But yeah, so there's like studies out there that say, you know, being physically active, you know, it can decrease your anxiety, your depression. And then if what I'm talking about today is having an accountability partner and just being around people. Like today, I went for a hike with my friends, and you know, even just doing anything, just walking on a trail, like burns calories, and just like being around people, getting to know them, just like the camaraderie, and it just like builds everything, and you just feel good about yourself. You know, it's beautiful, you're in nature, you're part of something bigger than yourself, and you're doing the added benefit of decreasing obesity of yourself and those around you that you're going with. Because, you know, we're all in this together. But here's the thing. You're like, Seth, I don't got time for that. I don't got time to go on a hike every day. I'm saying, get outside. When you get home from work, go on a walk with your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your significant other, your who, whatever, a dog, your cat, your grandma. Just go with somebody, you know, you get to talk about your day, say what you ate for lunch, you know, maybe change your diet. You can just go over some diet plans, you know, why not kill two birds with one stone? A rule of thumb is that you burn 100 calories per mile if you weigh 180 pounds, or you burn 65 calories per mile if you're 120 pounds. Because it all depends, you know, on your metabolism. Like, everybody's going to burn different amounts for the same distance because you're putting in different effort. But anything is better than nothing. You got to get out and do stuff. And look how fun it is. Here's a clip.
Hi, my name's Seth. Do you have a moment to talk about obesity?
Guys, I can't go on. I can't do this.
No, you can do it, man. You can do it. It's all about losing that weight.
Yeah, perseverance.
Wow.
Gosh dang, that's pretty.
I need a refill.
Oh, kill it.
So, just got done with the hike. Did you have fun? Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Yeah.